Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Stewart Field here at Hunterdon Central Regional High School. For HCTV Channel 27, I'm Dan Millay, joined alongside Tom Roboto. Today we've got the Red Devils going up against the Freehold Township Patriots in the Central Jersey Group 4 semifinals. So we'll send it over to Tom for some facts about the teams.
We got two high-powered teams here. Central is 17-3-1. They're winning 7 of their last 8, while Freehold Township is 14-4-1. They've won 8 of their last 9. They're coming off a win over Heightstown 4-0 in the sectional quarterfinals. Central beat Princeton last Friday 4-0.
So both teams coming off 4-0 wins in the quarterfinals. A win tonight would grant them a spot in the sectional finals. So obviously both teams want to get there. Central would be reaching that stage for the second year in a row. A lot of these players on the team now were a part of that sectional final team last year. So they know what it feels like to get there. They know what it takes. Looks like the Patriots are going to start off with the ball here. Waiting for the refs. And here we go. Patriots play it back. Central tried to rush up. Here's Jordan Rosenheim on the right side for the Red Devils, trying to make a play on defense. And Freehold tried to play that up their left side, just sent it into the corner, though. That's definitely one thing to note. The field's going to be very slick. We've got new turf, and it's been raining all day. It's raining pretty hard right now, so ball's really going to be skidding along the ground. Players are going to have to adjust to that and, you know, maybe make softer passes so that they don't overpower any passes and, you know, slide the ball past their teammates. Rosenheim on the throw-in. Sent up, but Patriots get a foot on it. Sierra Adams trying to win it back. She passes it backwards. That's Emily Mason. Played towards the middle to J.B. Goldfarb. To the left side now for Central. Rachel Reed's got it. Making a couple moves. Tries to send it up. Kylie Rossler's got it now. Plays it in the middle. Freehold gets it back. Gemma gets it, heads it towards the middle, but Patriots head it right back. Here's Rossler. Ball's deflected, sent into the air. Here's Rachel Reed. She's got possession. Tries to get it up to Agrillo in the middle, but good play there by the defense. Goldfarb sends it back to Reed. To Richards, to Mason. Good move there to get past a couple defenders. Gets it up to Goldfarb. To Agrillo now. Tried to play it between her legs. Good play by the defense, though. Stopped her. Red Devils will have a throw-in, though. Reed tries to get up to Agrillo. Doesn't get there, but Rossler's got it. Sends it back to Goldfarb. Tried to lift that to Adams. Ends up getting to Zulo. She tried to scoot it over to Adams, and she does now. Going to have to hustle to keep it in bounds, but Freehold plays it out. Rosenheim up for the throw-in. Tried to play it to Zulo, but Zulo was unable to control it. Patriots will have a goal kick.
Looks like this game is going to be pretty much a lot of defense. Seems like most of the games we've done together, they've been all defense. Both defenses looking pretty thick so far. Not letting anything happen, but it's still early.
Yeah, it's probably going to be tough on offense to make a lot of consecutive passes and kind of get an offensive flow with the weather being how it is. Obviously, teams not always really used to playing in weather like this, especially on turf, where the ball can kind of slip and slide, and players can slip and slide. We saw the boys' game yesterday, which they won 2-1. they also played in rainy conditions like this, and every time anybody went down for a slide tackle, they would usually slide a lot further than they thought they would, at least initially. They got used to it as the game went on. But there was definitely an adjustment period, and I'm sure the girls today will find that same fact too. As Adams gets it on the right side. Gets it up to Zulo, team leader in goals. Makes a move towards the right side, cuts back now. Good play by the defense. Central wins it back, sends it towards the middle to Rossler. She plays it backwards to Mason. To Gemma, to Rossler on the one-touch pass. A good shot there by Rossler, missed the goal wide right.
Yeah, the first chance for both teams in this game. Ball goes wide right of the net, but looks like it's going to be a corner kick for Hunterdon Central. Another great opportunity.
Yeah, looks like it was deflected by the defender. Yeah, definitely the best opportunity for Central so far, like you said. Rossler's got it. Gives it back to Mason. Rossler tries to send it inside, but nobody there. Looks like Central might have been called for offside there. Don't think they would have had a play on offense anyway, as Freehold was able to clear the ball out. But the Patriots will take a free kick. That one's sent to the Freehold 45. Launched into the air, but goes out of bounds. Rosenheim has got the throw-in. Backwards to Mason, now to Richards. Reed's wide open on the left side. To Mason in the middle. Goldfarb tried to get it over to Reed. Got deflected, though. Rosenheim wins it back.
Every time the ball, going back to the field conditions, every time the ball slides along the field, a bunch of water spews up in the air, so. Water could be puddling on the ground, so that could make an effect on the game, too.
Yeah, you can definitely see, with, like you said, with every pass, a ton of water just comes up every time the ball hits the turf. We just saw it there as well. Agrillo's got it. Good shot there from her, but missed wide right again.
Yeah, that was a great effort there. Agrillo fell to the ground, still made an effort, kick, just wide of the right.
Grillo played really well in Central's last win. She scored 2 goals in that game. Helped Central advance to this sectional semifinal. Patriots making a run now. Here's Richards on the right side, trying to make a play on defense. Still coming, though. Good play by Richards. Central just trying to clear it now. Richards able to send it out of bounds. Freehold still got it. Mason deep now. It looked like that was Rachel Reed in the corner. She's got a throw in now. Freehold still got it. Pushing up on offense. That ball deflected out of bounds. Patriots still have it. That ball tossed over to Mason. She clears it. Sends it all the way to the 50, but headed back by Freehold. Gemma trying to win it, but she can't do so. Zulo on the right side. Tried to play it up to Gemma, but ball just trickled out of bounds.
other than those two opportunities Central had, that shot by Grillo and that shot earlier that went right in the net, seems like both teams just can't get the ball past around the 30-yard line. Just both defenses really thick, not letting anything happen.
Well, Central trying to make Freehold's defense work even more here. They've got pretty good position. Rosenheim tried to get that to Adams. Defense knocked it out. Rosenheim will get another throw in. Again, Rosenheim tried to get that to Zulo, but had a couple defenders on her. Ball ended up out of bounds. Patriots will have another goal kick. That one sent to about the 50. Making its way towards Central's goal. Mason trying to clear it. Goldfarb trying to make a play now. Here's Gemma. Attacks that ball. Gets it up to Zulo. At least she tried to, but it was intercepted. That ball sent towards the middle. Good job by Reed. Stop that play before it became anything too dangerous. She's taking it herself. Ooh, tried to get it up to Agrillo, but you saw that ball. Didn't even bounce, just skidded along the turf. Definitely something to take into account during this game, I'm sure. Central players will get used to it, but so far looks like they're still adjusting to the temperature and the conditions of the field. Reed's got another throw in here. A little more than 10 minutes gone. Still tied at zero. Patriots trying to make a run up the right side now. They don't have numbers. Central does a good job of getting back on defense, but a little bit of a misplay there from Rosenheim. Mason now. Rosenheim tries to clear it, but Freehold's right there. Deflected off Goldfarb. Oh, and she goes down. Got tripped up there, but a whistle from the referee. Central will have a free kick.
That was Freehold's best push of the game, 12 minutes in. Central now looking to make a push to get this first goal on the board.
Mason takes the free kick. Patriots tried to control it, but could not do so. Sends it out of bounds. Reed has got a throw in. Zulo's all the way up now. That ball was off of Grillo, so Freehold will take a throw in. Central's got a throw in now. A bit of a stalemate here. Neither team able to keep possession. Zulo plays it over her head. Lost the ball there. Oh, the defense trips over it. And here's Rossler winning it back for Central. Gets it over to Adams, trying to cross over the field. Ooh, tried to play it up to Gemma. Was deflected, though. And Rosenheim will have another throw-in on the right side. Central's had this position a couple times. They haven't really done anything with it, though. Ooh, that ball nearly a corner for Central. Almost went out of bounds off Freehold. Gemma battling for it in the corner. She wins it, but sends it out of bounds.
Yeah, as you were saying, Central seems like they're getting a lot of these same possessions, and seems like they just keep getting the ball out of bounds right along the goal line, but not able to get anything going.
Patriots ready to send it up. On one bounce there, gets away, and Reed's got it again. Rossler cuts back towards the middle, backwards to Goldfarb. She's unable to take the pass. Trying to get back on defense now as Freehold's making another push. Got some room on the right side. Send it towards the middle. Good job by Richards there just to disrupt the pass. Nice slide there from Kylie, but Freehold still knocking at the door. Rosenheim on the right side is going to try to clear it. Goes right to the Patriots, though. Adams plays it back to Rosenheim. Rosenheim gets it up. Agrillo and Gemma up on offense, unable to retain the ball for Central. Here's Zulo cutting towards the middle. Sends it to the goal, but an easy catch for the Freehold goalkeeper.
Yeah, Zulo, the leading goal scorer on this team with 14 goals, not able to put the ball in a spot where the goalie is unable to get it. So game remains tied, 25 minutes left to go in this first half.
That ball sent to the 40. Rossler trying to win it back. Reed's on the left side now. Tried to send it up to Rossler. Zulo unable to make it to that pass. Adams gets it to Gemma. Goldfarb gets it up. Gemma had a touch on it, but unable to control it, and Zulo unable to run it down. So another opportunity not capitalized on by Central. Patriots send that one down the right side. Here's Richards. She's able to send it out. Freehold's got a throw in on the right side. Central unable to clear it. Richards trying to do so now. She can't. Rossler tried to play it, but bit of a bad shot there by Freehold. Missed wide left.
Yeah, Freehold has yet to put a shot on goal so far. Central's got three.
Central will have a goal kick here. Looks like Mason will take it. That one deflected off the Patriots. Rosenheim will take a throw in on the right side. Rosenheim will take another one from about the same spot. Zulo gets that in the middle. Carnevale trying to make a play on it, but Adams able to intercept the pass. Reed on the left side to Carnevale. Makes a move towards the middle. Sends it to Goldfarb. Gets it to Reed now. Central finally able to string some passes together on offense. Reed making a run towards the goal. Leaves it off to Agrillo, but bit of a bad touch by Agrillo. Goldfarb wins it back. Sends it to Reed again. Richards in the back. To Mason, trying to cross over. Tried to get it up to Zulo. Pass was off the mark, and now Freehold trying to make another run. Bit of a misplay there by Richards, but Reed's got it. Nice move there by Zulo. Gets it up to Carnevale. Back to Zulo. Putting a burst of speed on, running down the right side. Leaves it towards the middle. Ball's loose, but a kick save by the goalie. A really good play there from the Patriots goalkeeper.
Yeah, sort of a desperation save. Agrillo and Gemma were moving in on the goalie. She just stuck her legs out and deflected that one out of bounds.
It looks like Central will have a corner here. Mason will take it. Sent towards the middle, up and above the goal, though. So nobody able to make a play on it. Patriots will have a goal kick.
That one sort of hurts. Those are always good opportunities for to get a goal, but Central look to keep Freehold out of their zone and just get the ball back, get another chance.
Yeah, that last run on offense was definitely Central's best possession of the game. Thought maybe the corner kick would be the opportunity they'd finally capitalize on after such a positive push down the field. Wasn't meant to be, obviously. Adams has got it for the Devils, though. So gets sent out of bounds. Rosenheim will take a throw-in. Here's Agrillo. Another misplay there by Agrillo, and Freehold's able to win it back. That one's sent towards Central's goal. Good play by Reed. Really good play by Reed there to control that and send it out. Mason's got it on the right side now. Gets it up to Gemma. Sent out by the Patriots. It'll be another throw-in for Central. Rosenheim gets it to Zulo. She sends it up to Carnevale in the middle. Touch to Adams. That's sent towards the box. Agrillo trying to run it down. Unable to keep it in bounds.
Looked like she slipped up there in the corner.
Yeah, it's possible that some water might be collecting down there. We can't really tell, but it's still raining now. It's been raining hard all game, and it was for hours prior to the game. Reed tries to head that one forward, but deflected to Goldfarb. Richards gets it to Mason in the back. Mason sends it up, but good play there by Freehold. That pass skids all the way back, but Mason able to control it. Good pass there to Reed. That gets deflected away. Adams gets it to Carnevale. Good pass there from Gemma. Here's Zulo. She gets by the goalie, and she puts it in. A beautiful play there by Zulo. She beat the defender, and then she got past the goalie, set herself up and put it in the top left corner of the net. And finally, the Red Devils have taken a 1-0 lead.
Yeah, that would go for her 15th goal of the year, extending her team lead. A beauty, puts the Devils up 1-0.
Yeah, that's 15 goals now on the year for Zulo. And that was a really pretty one, a really good set of moves there. Central now finding themselves with a 1-0 lead with about 18 minutes left in the first half. Freehold trying to make a push up the left side now. Getting towards the middle. That's deflected off Rossler. Patriots making a push now in the right corner. That ball's deflected out of bounds by Reed.
Corner kick coming up for the Patriots. Their first corner of the game, and it will be their first opportunity to score.
That's sent inside, deflected into the air, and just skids out of bounds.
The defensive Central just shut that opportunity down real quick.
Yeah, it's almost impossible to run balls on the ground down today, as they're not, you know, bouncing or rolling as they usually would. They're just kind of skidding. And there's a whistle against the Red Devils. So the Patriots will have a free kick from in pretty close. Yeah, within Central's 20. So this is a really good chance for the Patriots to tie it up here. Freehold kind of talking out what they're going to do with this play now. Looks like they're ready. Central's got the wall of defenders in front of the kicker. That one sent towards the goal, but right there is Ava Gillikin for an easy save. Ball was struck right at her. That was really the first time Ava Gillikin's had to do anything all game. This Central defense has been pretty good. Rossler gets that to Mason. One touch there from Zulo, but not quite on target. Was meant to go to Adams. Agrillo tried to win that one back, but Carnevale picks off the pass. Adams plays it back to Reed. Carnevale tried to play it back, but Freehold was right there waiting for it. Mason sent that up right to Freehold. Here's Reed again on defense. She's been put to work a ton tonight. Seems like this is Freehold's favorite place to attack from. There's a shot, but nowhere near the goal.
Ever since Central got that first goal, Freehold's just been on a mission. They're making so many offensive pushes, and they keep possession here with another corner kick.
This one's up. A really good pass there. And they just send that one way above the goal, so Central will have another goal kick. All of Central's all of Freehold's corner kicks have been really good passes. They just haven't been able to put any of them in. Definitely something to look out for Central. You want to limit their corner kick opportunities as much as you possibly can. And that pass goes right to Zulo. She's got a lot of room to work with, sends it towards the middle. Tried to get it to Colossi. Looked like she had a ton of room to work with it herself. Instead opted to pass.
Yeah, she might have jumped the gun a little bit early, but looked like that pass deflected off a defender and went out of Colossi's reach.
Yeah, from our view, looked like she might have had a better opportunity to just take it herself, but obviously you like the unselfish play from your best offensive player.
Yeah, it was good to see.
Reed will take a throw in now. Tried to get it up to Colossi. She had a couple defenders on her. There's Carnevale in the middle, gets it to Rossler, puts one move on and sends it to the goal, but wide left. A nice move there from Rossler, but she was a little bit far out, so couldn't quite get much on that.
Central's sixth shot on goal of the game.
Patriots have another goal kick. There's about 13 minutes left here in the first half. Central's got that 1-0 lead on the goal from Karina Zulo, her team leading 15th of the year. Reed will take a throw in. Tried to get it to Zulo, but just went over her head. Reed makes a good play there. Gets past two defenders. Cuts back.
Reed with a series of good moves there.
Now Freehold making a run. Here's Mason and Richards both there in the back, and a good play by Richards just to disrupt the offensive player there, as she could have had a free run at the goal. But once again, the Patriots will have a corner kick.
On that previous rush there, that was number four for Freehold, Ryan Lanner, their leading scorer with 11 goals.
This one's sent inside on the corner, but deflected away. Still up in the air. Central just trying to get it out of their box. And that ball goes out of bounds. Central will have a throw in. Reed will take it. Still got a ways to go. Buried deep on their side of the field. Reed sends it up. Ball skids past the defense, but Gemma unable to win it. Zulo tried to deflect that ball, couldn't do so. Reed's got another throw in. A Freehold player goes down there.
That's Ryan Leonard, their leading scorer. Went down hard. Not the best sight for Freehold. But she's back up. Looks like she's going to go right back in and get back to playing.
Looks like she might have hit her tailbone. Kind of holding her lower back there. So the Patriots will have another free kick from really good distance for them. Just a little bit beyond the 20. They send that one in, but wide of the goal. Looked pretty close, but Ava Gillikin seemed to be tracking it the whole way. She didn't even make an attempt for that ball. Seemed like she knew immediately that it was going to be wide.
I'd say that's easy. Freehold's best shot or chance of the game.
And that ball skids past it again. Here's Colossi trying to make a run on offense, but sent away by the defense. Sent into Gemma. She plays it towards the middle to Colossi. Back now, Goldfarb has it in the middle. Gets it to Colossi. To Zulo on the left side now. She cuts back towards the middle. She keeps it in bounds. Nice move there. Sends it towards the middle. Here's Gemma, but unable to put that one in. Tried to kind of do a half bicycle kick there. Ended up out of bounds, wide right.
Yeah, Zulo was putting on a show in that left corner. She was making so many moves, but Central unable to take advantage and remains 1-0.
Patriots have another goal kick here. Sent to all the way to the 50. Deflected out of bounds by the Patriots. Red Devils will take another throw in. Reed will take this one. Looks like the rain has kind of let up here. Not raining as hard as it was before, for the moment at least. Zulo goes down. The Red Devils have a free kick here. Rossler looks like she's going to take it. Now she leaves it off for Mason. At about Freehold's 35. Mason can definitely send it in. She lifts it. Punched away. Oh, Carnevale had an open goal. The goalkeeper was on the ground. But she just sent it into the air, well above the goal. And the Patriots will have yet another goal kick.
Yeah, golden opportunity there. But Carnevale unable to capitalize on it.
That one's sent to the 40. Rossler tried to make a play on it, but Ball's bounced all the way back to Reed. Goldfarb in the middle now. Got a couple offensive players on her. It's taken away. Here's Reed in the left corner. Reed has really been put to work in that left corner. Seems like every time Freehold's making a push on offense, it's from this same position. So give props to Reed for kind of preserving this 1-0 lead so far. She's put in a lot of good work on defense.
As a whole, the Central defense has been pretty much unstoppable. Not too many chances for Freehold, but Reed has definitely been the headline of the defense so far.
Mason gets that up. Controlled by the Patriots. A little of a misplay there, and Rosenheim comes away with it. Freehold wins it back, though. Making a run towards the middle now. Sent inside. Ooh, a better pass there. And Central's in trouble, but thankfully pass got away from the intended player, so it was an easy play for Gilliken in goal. That one's sent past midfield. Zulo's trying to make a play on it. Good job there by Freehold to keep that in bounds, but Zulo tries to win it back. Sent up by the Patriots. Reed heads it. Rossler had two defenders on her. She tried to win it, but Freehold will take another throw-in. Here's Gemma now. She wins it in the middle of the field. Good pass there. That's Carnevale. Tried to get it to Colossi, but again, not a great pass. Colossi trying to win it back on the sideline. Goes out of bounds. They're now less than 5 minutes in this first half. Still 1-0 Central. Mason launches that one up the right side. Goes out of bounds. Good job there by both Richards and Mason. Like you said, Central defense all around has been really solid all first half. Here comes Rossler. Chips it up to Gemma. But again, the conditions of the field being as they are, ball just skidded away from Gemma. Would have been a good pass on dry turf probably, but ball just took off a little bit, and it was an easy play for Freehold's goalkeeper. Rossler again tried to send it deep, but too far up. Patriots goalkeeper almost let that go out of bounds. Bit of a misplay. Instead of just picking it up with her feet, she tried to kind of, or picking it up with her hands, I should say. She tried to play it with her feet, but she's got it. She sends it to the 40. Deflected off the ref. Freehold's got it. They've got some space to work with. They're coming down their right side again. Goldfarb with a good play on it. Freehold breaks away, though. And Rosenheim did a good job there of not hitting that out of bounds, ensuring that Central would get the ball back on a goal kick.
Also appeared there. Freehold put a nice pass across the face of the goal, but Rosenheim was there instead of a Freehold player, and Central keeps the ball out of their net.
Patriots have still got it on the right side. And they'll take a throw in. Mason in the middle now. Gets it up to Goldfarb. To Gemma. Tried to play it back. Nobody was there, though. Here's Carnevale. She gets it back to Reed. A couple defenders on Carnevale, but she gets it to Rossler quickly. Nice pass there. Zulo just had too many defenders to beat. Had two on her. Zula will take the throw-in, or is she waiting for Reed?
Looks like there was a substitution for Central. I think Kira Adams came in for Nicolette Carnevale.
Whistle blown there. Patriots will take it. Under 2 minutes now in the first half. Richard sends it up, tried to get it to Adams, who just checked in, as you said. Goldfarb plays it back to Rosenheim, back to Goldfarb. Puts on a move there, gets it to Mason in the backfield. Gets past one defender, and now another. Adams gets it up. Here's Colossi on the right side. Cuts towards the middle. Leaves it off to Rossler. And that's deflected by the defense, but ball still loose. Up in the air now, and the goalkeeper for Freehold has got it.
Series of chances there for Central. Lucky play for Freehold. Their defender blocked it, standing right in front of the goalkeeper. Game remains 1-0 with 42 seconds to go in this first half.
Yeah, the Patriots trying to make their last run here. Central wins it back, though. Here comes Zulo. Up on the left side. Cuts towards the middle. Sends it in the goal, but scooped up by the goalkeeper again. 15 seconds now. Mason clears that out. And there is the final buzzer. So after the first 40 minutes of play, Central's got a 1-0 lead on the goal by Karina Zulo. But I think we could both agree, Tom, that the story of the first half has been the defenses for both teams.
Yeah, we've been talking about defense all afternoon. Just constant Central, just not letting anything happen. Only four shots in this first half. Looks like Central began to break through the defensive Freehold. They got 9 shots on goal. They got a goal, and in the past minute, they had a bunch of chances to score one, but unable to.
So with that, we will see you at the start of the second half. Welcome back to HCTV Channel 27. I'm Dan Millay, joined alongside Tom Roboto, ready to start the second half here as the Hunterdon Central Red Devils currently hold a 1-0 lead against the Freehold Township Patriots. This is the Central Jersey Group 4 semifinals. The winner of this game will go on to play in the finals, of course, and play for a chance to win the section. Central was coming into this tournament the 1 seed, Freehold the 5 seed. This is definitely the best team that Central's played so far in this tournament. And it's showed so far. It's been a really tight game, only 1-0, as we mentioned. Central's defense, though, has really been as good as they can be so far. Looks like Central's going to start with the ball to begin the half. Let's pass back to Rossler. She sends it deep to Zulo, but bounces out of bounds. Patriots will take it. Rosenheim able to play it to Goldfarb in the middle. Zulo makes a move, but she's got a defender on her. The only time Zulo really had a one-on-one opportunity in this entire game was when she was able to score her goal. So whenever she's able to get any space and free herself up, she can usually do a lot for you offensively. She just hasn't been able to do that a lot today. The Freehold defense kind of been all over her. Rosenheim will take a throw-in. Tries to get it to Gemma. She's battling with a defender. Ball gets sent away. Rossler back to Goldfarb now. That's sent across the field. Here's a Grillo on the left side now. Tried to get that inside to Gemma, but it was just sent away. Gemma had a couple defenders on her. Reed with the throw in to Gemma. That ball sent inside. Bounce between two Freehold defenders. Agrillo trying to run it down now for Central. Able to deflect it, but the Patriots have still got it. Good job by Mason. Immediately wins the ball back.
It's a prime example right there of the Central defense just make the smallest attempt to get in their zone, and they just shut you down and put the ball right back into the hands of the offense.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. The entire kind of back line for Central of Rosenheim, Richards, Mason, and Reed, they've all played really well today. And like you said, they haven't even really given Freehold many opportunities to make runs on offense because every time they get in close to the goal, or at least most of the time, it's sent away almost immediately. Central's got a couple of defenders up now. Zulo all the way back. Freehold still got it. That one's sent in deep. Richards sends it up in the air. That ball headed out of bounds. It'll be a goal kick for Central. Mason will take it. Sends it up, but headed right back by Freehold. Rosenheim able to send it up in the air. Sent back again by Freehold. Good pass inside there, but an easy play for Ava Gillikin in the back. She'll choose to punt it. Gets it all the way to the 50. Rossler battling for the ball, but again, Freehold comes away with it and sends it to Gillikin. Central hasn't even really been able to get it past their own, or I should say the 50, out of their own half of the field. Finally, they're able to. Gemma tries to head it up to Zulo. Rossler trying to win it now. Good job by Mason there. Ball continues to scoop back further and further for Freehold. Rossler trying to make a play on the ball now. Good job by Adams. She's there to get it back. Gives it to Rosenheim. She sends it deep. Gemma, bit of a missed touch there, played it back. And a trip up there from Freehold. Rossler gets it. Gets it to Zulo. Zulo puts on a burst of speed, gets into the right corner. The defense just all over her, though. Gets it right back. Really good play on defense there by Freehold. Goldfarb finally comes up to challenge the ball, and she deflects it, but the Patriots have still got it. So the Patriots, starting off this half very strong. They've had possession of the ball for probably the majority of the time. For a while, they were making that push on offense. Now, kind of controlling it on their own half of the field. Central really unable to keep the ball for any lengthy period of time as that one's sent to Zulo in the right corner. Puts a move on, cuts towards the middle, but again, three defenders on Zulo right there in the right corner. She's got no room to work with. Can't really get it to any teammates either.
Looks like Freehold just, maybe their plan is just lock down Zulo because they know she's their best player, so lock her down. Maybe we'll slow down the Central offense.
Rossler goes down there. It'll be a free kick for Central. Right about where a corner kick would be. Rossler will take it. Set on the ground in the middle. Here's Zulo. Gives it back to Rossler. She gets it inside, but it's batted away. Goldfarb able to control it. Reed gets it up the left side. Agrillo loses it, though. Seems like maybe Agrillo's having a little bit of trouble kind of handling the ball today with, you know, the turf being so wet. Her cleats are probably wet. The ball's definitely wet. So she's having a little bit of trouble containing and controlling the ball right now. It's probably different conditions than she's used to playing in. There's a whistle from the referee.
Yeah, going back to what you just said, it's definitely got to be frustrating too because kind of noticed the whole team's been, both teams have been having trouble with the ball. Just the conditions are really screwing up things. But hasn't really affected teams too greatly, but still there.
And there you see it again, just as we're talking about it. That ball just skidded right past Freehold, tried to make a kick save and dive on the ground to keep it inside or inbounds, but couldn't do so. Central will have another throw-in. Freehold wins it back again. Making another push on offense here. Good pass inside. It's the leading scorer right here for Freehold, and she coughs it up. Goldfarb sends it up the left side. A nice pass there to Agrillo. Again, Agrillo just unable to kind of get that pass and do anything with it. Couldn't control it.
Looks like she just slipped a little bit there, too.
Goldfarb sends that up to Adams, but it's deflected. Here's Gemma now. Richards sends that up one touch. Here's Agrillo. She sends it inside. Zulo's there. Takes a high bounce. Nobody there for Central. Gemma was a little bit too far back. There was a defender in between her and Zulo that made the play on that ball. Rosenheim will take a throw in. Adams trying to head it up. Good job there by Adams. Had a couple defenders on her. Got it to Zulo, who's wide open. That one deflected out of bounds. Central will have another throw-in. Rosenheim will take it again. That one's into Gemma. She plays it in the air. Sent out by the defense again. Good job by Richards. Richards and Mason were the only two back, so if Richards doesn't control that pass and send it back, could have been pretty bad for Central. Would have had not too many players back on defense. Again, Richards sends it back towards the offense. Gemma gets it to Zulo. Ooh, Gemma took a shot, but got deflected away.
Seems like the Freehold defense has come out much stronger in the second half, playing much better than this, playing much better than what they played in the first half.
And there's a pass for Freehold sent up. Good opportunity for them. And it misses wide right, hit the side of the goal, and went out of bounds. It'll be a goal kick for Central. Definitely the scariest play by Freehold. That was their best chance to score so far. And thankfully for Central, they weren't able to capitalize.
Yeah, their scariest play, and also by their scariest player, that was number four, Ryan Leonard, their leading scorer.
Goldfarb gets it up to Adams. Adams goes down, and there's a whistle. Right at about Central's 45, it looks like. Mason will take it. Bounces that one inside. Adams tries to make a play. It's sent in by a Grillo. Zulo trying to make a play inside, but once again, a Freehold defense sends it out. Rosenheim making a run at it, but sent back out. Goldfarb gets it, though. Tries to send it to a Grillo on the left side. She's in the corner now. Dancing on the sideline, trying to keep it in bounds. And she goes down, and Freehold able to send it out.
Yeah, nice play there in the back corner by Grillo along that sideline, keeping the ball in bounds, making a bunch of moves. Central regains possession.
Yeah, Reed will take the throw in here. Look, she tried to get that one to Adams, but it was headed out again. She'll take another throw in. For a Grillo that time, sent out again. She'll take another throw in. About 27 minutes left here in this second half. Still a 1-0 Central lead. Neither team able to score so far in the second half. Mason takes a shot at goal. Wow, a nice shot there too. That was from about the 25. Almost got it in the back right corner, bottom right corner of the net.
That was pretty much the first time the Freehold defense has allowed something to happen for Central in the second half. They've been pretty stellar for this second half, but 26 to go.
I really like that shot by Mason, because Central's had a little bit of trouble getting the ball inside of Freehold's box, as the defense has done a really good job of just eliminating any chances they have on offense before they even come to fruition. So maybe some long shots by Mason or anybody else who's kind of a little bit further back could could do some good for Central, just get a different look offensively.
Yeah, Mason's going to feel confident about those shots, too. She's got 8 goals in the year, so some of them are going to go in.
Yeah, Mason's probably got the strongest foot on the team, as she pretty much takes every free kick on her half of the field. Obviously, she's playing back on defense all the time. As Freehold's making a run towards the goal now. There's a shot, but that's wide right by quite a bit.
Going back to Emily Mason, she's committed to Rutgers, and she's only a sophomore, so Central has 2 more years of her after this year, so definitely something to look forward to if you're the coach for Hunterdon Central.
Yeah, Zulo being a junior now, and like you said, Mason being a sophomore next year, could be another really good year for Central, as they've had a really good year this year, had a really good year the year previously as well. Also looks like the rain's starting to come back down. You can see it reflecting in the lights. As here's a Grillo wide open on the right side. Touch into the corner. And that's sent away. It'll be a corner kick for Central.
Looks like the pass to Grillo had too much oomph on it. Wasn't able to catch up to it. Caught up to it too late near the sideline, but goes off a Freehold defender, and Central's got a good opportunity here with the corner kick.
Rossler's got it. She sends it in. Nobody able to gain possession, still bouncing around. Rossler again on the right side. Back in the corner, sends it inside again, and it'll go out for another corner for Central. Same side, and Rossler will take it again. Here we go again, sent inside again. Goldfarb from the outside, and that's in. What a great shot from Jamie Goldfarb outside of the box for Central. Ball just ricocheted out, she one-touched it into the back of the net. A beautiful shot there from Jamie Goldfarb. Wow, and Central now takes a 2-0 lead, a beautiful shot. Really, really good play there by Goldfarb.
Yeah, she was wide open, had a wide open shot. Able to put that one past the goalie, Freehold. The freshman put Central up 2-0.
Yeah, really, really good shot there by Goldfarb. No hesitation at all. She was pretty far behind, like I said. She was outside of the box, but just decided to let it fly. Scooted through the entire defense behind the goalie. A really great shot. As here comes Freehold trying to cut the deficit in half as quickly as possible, but Richards sends it to Rosenheim on the left side, battling in the corner now. Ball still in bounds. She tries to get it up. Rossler sends that out.
Going back to that Goldfarb goal, another long shot. Mason took one before. It was unable to go in, but Goldfarb took a shot, and that one went in, so they're definitely paying off just the effort.
And there's a shot by Leonard, leading scorer for Freehold, as we've mentioned a couple times. Gillikin made the save. Here's Gemma now on offense for Central. Nice stop there by Adams. Still battling for it. She's got it. Sends it back to Goldfarb. Grillo goes down battling with a defender. Goldfarb on the left side still. She goes down, and there's a call for Central. They'll have a free kick. Mason's inside the 40. She'll take it. Sends it inside. Nearly went in the goal. Nobody seemed to touch it. Oh, maybe it was deflected by the defense. That's why I missed wide right. So Central will have another corner kick.
That previous play was another prime example of Mason's extremely strong leg. She was at the 40, pretty much kicked that one almost to the goal in the air. But Central will look to go up 3-0 on this corner kick.
Yeah, Mason or Rossler will take it again. Inside. That time nobody outside of the box waiting to put it in. Now here comes Freehold. A ton of Central defenders back. Gillikin up now. She'll make the save. Scoops it up without a problem. And a nice punt there from Gillikin all the way to the other half of the field. Setting up the Central offense here. There's a pass to Adams. Good pass to Gemma. She's running from the left side. Battling with a defender, and ball gets sent out. Will be a throw in for Central. Reed will take it. Halfway through the second half now, 20 minutes gone. Central up 2-0 now. As Colossi got one up in the air. Play was made by the goalkeeper. And ball went out first, looks like. So a goal kick for Freehold.
That was a good one there. It was kind of a floater. Looked like it had a chance to go in, but the Freehold goalie was on top of it.
Yeah, and even if it hadn't gone in, could have been a good setup for a teammate, so definitely a good play, as you said. Goldfarb's got it. She goes down again in the middle, and she gets the call again right at the midfield marker.
Seems like these wet conditions are sometimes going in the favor of teams. They're falling, and then sometimes those falls can lead to calls and whistles, so...
Mason gets it over to Reed. Plays it on the sideline to Zulo. Making a move towards the middle, lifts a shot up. Easy play for the goalkeeper. Now it's punted to Freehold's 45. Deflected even further, though. Mason sends it right back. Ooh, Colossi might have gotten hit in the back, but Adams has got it now. Tries to get it up to Agrillo. Bit of a bad pass there. Agrillo couldn't quite rein it in. Oh, Mason tried to leave it off for her teammate Richards there, but she wasn't ready for it. Rosenheim plays it up. Rossler making a run on the right side. Able to keep it out of bounds. She gets shoved over from behind, though. It'll still be a throw-in for Central. No whistle on the push.
Good play there by Kylie Rossler. Seemed like she was boxing out the Freehold defender along the sideline. Able to keep the ball for Central.
Richards gets it over to Reed. Now Rossler's got it in the middle. Nice pass there to Zulo. Takes a shot. Could have been a cross as well. Still in play. Goes out of bounds.
That pass by Karina Zulo just out of reach for Agrillo. Good opportunity there, but Central unable to capitalize on it. Another corner kick coming up here.
Yeah, once again, looked like Zulo could have taken a shot there, opted to pass. That's the second time she's had a play like that in this game. First one was in the first half. We thought maybe she could have taken a shot on goal instead, elected to pass, did the same there. But like you said, it'll be a corner for Central. Good pass there, but right to the goalie. Decides to throw it out. Reed ends up with it. Gets it up the sideline. Here comes Zulu again. Defense gobbles it up, though. Adams back to Goldfarb. Up to Mason now. I'd like to see Mason doing a little more on offense, pushing up a little bit. As you said, she does have 8 goals on the year, as well as 10 assists, so she's primarily contributed on defense, but she can contribute a lot offensively for this team.
It's always good to have an offensive player that can play defense. Just adds a kind of a mix, I guess you could say, for your team.
Patriots on the throw-in. Mason controls it. Gets it up the sideline to Colossi, now to Rossler. In the middle, it's his Adams. Tried to leave it off to Zulo. A bit of a bad pass, though. Didn't have enough on that one.
Looked like Adams had an opportunity to take a shot there, but she chose to try to find Zulo, and she was unable to receive the pass.
Yeah, I agree. She was wide open in the middle. Definitely would not have had a problem with her shooting that. Here comes Rossler trying to win it back. Goes to Mason instead. Up to Adams, now to Zulo on the left side. She tries to get it inside to one of her teammates. It's sent out, though. It'll be a throw in for Reed. Freehold's got it. Hard touch there. Rossler trying to win it back. And she gets it, but deflected again by the defense. Mason gets it right back up. Adams back to Goldfarb now. To Reed, now playing it back to Richards. Obviously, Central's got the 2-0 lead. Less than 14 minutes left now, so the clock is definitely on their side. They'll definitely try to kind of slow things down here. No need to press or rush with a lead going into the final stages of this game.
Seems like the tides have turned since the beginning of the second half. Beginning, Freehold was shutting down Central, but now Central is making so many pushes. They got that second goal by Goldfarb, and Freehold really hasn't been able to get it out of their own zone. They haven't really made too many offensive pushes. It's been all Central in the past around 20 minutes, I'd say.
Yeah, you maybe get the sense that the Patriots are starting to feel a little bit defeated, obviously, facing a really good opponent here, the number one seed in the tournament, Central. Kind of after that second goal, maybe starting to feel like they can't come back. You know, their psyche is kind of out of whack here. Still got a lot of game to go, though. Goldfarb able to win it back. Gets it to Adams. She sends it up. Gemma and Zulu are both there. Neither of them able to get on it. Good play by Goldfarb, though. Sent out of bounds. It'll be a throw-in for Central. Reed throws that to Gemma. That ball goes out of bounds. Looks like it'll be Freehold's ball. Adams is battling for it. A couple defenders on her. She goes down. Play on, the ref says. Rossler now. Pushing up the left side. So he'll take a throw and gets it to Adams inside. Cleared out by the defense. Played into the middle again. Here's Adams. Ooh, had Gemma inside, but pass was deflected.
Yeah, Gemma was wide open right in front of the goalie, but defender for Freehold got in the way. Kicked that one out.
Seems like Central's had the most success this half on offense with those deep shots. Obviously, we saw Goldfarb scored on one, but Mason's had a good shot from deep. Adams has had a couple good opportunities, hasn't taken any. But with all these interior passes getting deflected and batted out, definitely be good to see some more outside attempts as they've served Central pretty well so far in the second half. Freehold continuing to make a push up the field. That one goes out of bounds off Goldfarb. They'll have another throw-in. Reed sends that one out. Freehold still got it. Central just fighting to keep them out of their box. That one sent inside. Good job by Richards. Really good play by Richards to hit it out of the air, and a nice play there from Gemma to get it up to Colossi. Trying to keep it in bounds, but it just kind of trickles out of play there. Less than 10 minutes now.
That last offensive push by Freehold has been their best probably in the second half. They haven't really had much time on the offensive side of the field for them, as Central has just been shutting them down from the latter half of this second half.
Goldfarb able to control that pass. Gets it up to Adams. Adams gets it back now. Gets it to Richards. Goldfarb goes down again. And that's played up. Here comes Gillikin. She'll scoop it up. Good job to make the assertive play there, the aggressive play on the ball. She takes her time on the punt, as she should. Less than 9 minutes now. 2-0 lead for Central still. And a whistle there. Didn't really see too much contact on that play, but Patriots will take it nonetheless. Mason clears that. Freehold in the corner. Richards deflected out of bounds. It'll be a corner kick for the Patriots.
This is a great opportunity for Freehold. It's late, but to get that first goal on the board. And if they can get that first goal, they'll have some momentum to try to tie it up.
That was a good pass in the box, but sent out of bounds. And Central, luckily, will come away with a goal kick.
Pretty much what's happened all game. Any attempt by Freehold to score, Central shuts it down immediately and sends the ball back to where they will try to get their third goal of the game.
Yeah, it'll start with Gillikin. She's got the goal kick. She lines it up. Sends it to about the 35. Cannavale's got it. Plays it back to Reed on the left side. Tries to send it deep, but deflected by Freehold. Reed will take a throw-in. Played up to a Grillo. Unable to contain that ball, so it goes out of bounds again. Central will take it.
Ready four, take four. Ready one,
Played that one right to Freehold. Goldfarb trying to win it back. Sends that one inside. Here's Agrillo. Just a little bit too much on that pass. Agrillo might have been able to make a play on it. Played in the air by Reed, sent back by Freehold. Good job there by Reed just to play that back to Gilliken instead of trying to clear it out with her head.
And Gilliken's going to take her time on this punt. Just kill as much time as you can. Just try to get this game over with. Secure the win. But we still have 5 minutes, 6 minutes to go. Anything could happen.
Yeah, still plenty of time for Freehold to mount a comeback here. Colossi and Agrillo both there. Now Rossler comes in to make a play. Colossi battling with a defender. She gets called for a foul. Freehold parents pretty upset about that one. They're making a run at the goal still. Goldfarb goes down again. Mason sends that up. Sent right back by the Patriots.
Goldfarb is down. She's hurt.
Yeah, it looked like she got kicked pretty hard. Honestly, was kind of surprised by the no call. Goldfarb sitting up now. Trainer and Coach Calhoun sitting alongside her.
Back up on her feet.
Yeah, she's able to walk it off, which is a good sign, of course. We are about ready to resume play here. 4 minutes and 49 seconds left.
Looks like Reed came back in for Goldfarb.
Freehold sends that inside. Gets away from the defense, but ends up out of bounds. It'll be a corner for the Patriots. Richards was able to come out and make a play on that one. Sends it out of bounds.
That was a weak kick there by Freehold.
It didn't seem like it was sent exactly where they wanted it to be. They're still knocking on Central's door, though. Central unable to clear it so far. Here's Rosenheim trying to do so. Good job there by Carnevale. Freehold trying to win a couple Oscars out here with these acting jobs. They're just going down left and right. Yeah, definitely the right call by the ref there, giving it back to Central.
Yeah, that was a great defensive play there by Agrillo. She took the ball away. Ball is up against the sideline. And Mason will send this one into the direction of Central's offense.
Agrillo again unable to corral that pass in. She's had a lot of trouble today. Rosenheim sends that one up. Rossler, a bit of a misplay. sent inside Central's box. Gillikin with an easy play on it. She'll take her time. Decides to roll it over to Mason. Mason can send it up herself, and she does. Ball goes out of bounds, though. 3 minutes left here. Rosenheim sends that one out. Freehold running out of time to score two goals and tie this game up. As looks like Colossi will check in for Agrillo. Rosenheim will throw it to Colossi. She gets it in the middle to Rossler. Back to Mason now. She clears it. Good job by Rossler to call off her teammates. Make the play on that ball. Carnevale sends it over the left side now to Zulo. Zulo tries to get it to Gemma. Ball deflected off Gemma, and it'll be Patriots ball on a throw-in. Less than 2 minutes now.
Pressure's really on now for Freehold. It's been on ever since they went down 2-0. But with under 2 minutes to go, season closing.
Yeah, Freehold definitely in desperation mode here, and there's a shot towards the goal. Ball took a nasty skid on the wet turf. Gillikin actually had to dive on it. Definitely the right play to make sure she was able to corral it in. Points that one to about the 45. Still trying to make a play here down the stretch. Rossler with a good slide there, but she gets called for a foul. That's a tough call to make. It's a minute left in the game. Just trying to make a play on defense, get the ball away from the offensive player. She's tabbed with a foul. The crowd pretty upset about that one. And honestly, could understand why. Freehold will take it, though. And they just send it way above the goal. Less than 30 seconds now, and it looks like Central is going to be moving on to the sectional final.
Gillikin will take her time on this goal kick.
Ten seconds now. And there is the final buzzer. Central wins 2-0. And they are moving on to the Central Jersey Group 4 final. First goal was scored by Karina Zulo, last one by Jamie Goldfarb on probably the best score of the game. A beautiful goal by her from the outside of the box. And just like that, Central is moving on, Tom.
Yeah, this game was a perfect example of what Central's defense brings to the table, a shutout. And that will do it for our broadcast here on ATTV Channel 27. Hunterdon Central takes the 2-0 win over Freehold, and they move on to the Central Jersey Group 4 Finals.
We thank you for tuning in. I'm Dan Millay with Tom Roboto.